Congratulations on your purchase of the Lascar USB temperature-only data logger from Healthcare Logistics. This device has the capability to capture over 16,000 readings within the measurement range of negative 35 to 80 degrees Celsius. In this video, I will discuss how to install the EasyLog software, how to configure the data logger, and how to read the alarms. I will also demonstrate how to collect and read the data. This video has multiple chapters. If you need to, you can save time by just jumping to the chapter you need. To begin, let's talk about the battery. A 1/2 AA battery is included and pre-installed. However, if you need to install or change your battery, you will need a small tool to remove the battery cover. I find that a jeweler screwdriver works best. Remove the cap and locate the small silver clip on the side of the data logger. Take the jeweler screwdriver and press down on the clip until you feel the cover give way. This may require a little practice. Remove the cover and replace or insert the battery. Paying attention to the polarity, you should notice the LED lights flash when the new battery is properly installed. Slide the cover back and you're ready to set up the data logger. Now, let me demonstrate how to install the EasyLog software. This software is necessary for you to use your data logger. It is used to configure the logger, download the data, read the data, as well as perform other functions. To begin, log into a computer that you will use to connect the data logger to. Make sure a USB port is available and the computer is running Microsoft Windows. Also, make sure you have permissions on the computer to install software. Open a web browser. I'll be using Microsoft Edge, and go to EasyLogUSB.com. At the top of the page, you will see the EasyLog USB software box and a download button. Click the download button and a small box should appear showing the name of the download file and the progress. When the download is complete, click on Open File. The installation is very basic. Just acknowledge the agreement and follow the prompts. When finished, click the Finish button. A second part of the install will immediately launch the USB device driver installation. The software will scan your system for a few moments, install the driver files, and then tell you the installation was successful. Now that the installation is complete, we need to set up and start the data logger. To begin, insert the data logger into a USB port and launch the EasyLog software. After a few moments, a menu should appear. Select the first option, set up and start the USB data logger. The first two options are very easy. Give the data logger a name, and if you want the temperature scale to be Fahrenheit or Celsius, I will change the name to Pharmacy Fridge next to the name and change the temperature scale to Fahrenheit. The third option is how often you want the data logger to log the temperature. The more frequent, the sooner the memory will fill up. The software conveniently shows you how long it will take to fill the logger's memory based on the frequency. Click the drop-down box and make a selection. For this demonstration, I will select 10 minutes, then click Next. The next window is for configuring alarm settings. You can choose to set a high or a low alarm by clicking the box next to the alarm. Check both boxes and you will receive alerts from both. With both boxes checked, you need to tell it when to activate the alarm, starting with the high alarm. I will click the drop-down box and select 45 degrees. For the low alarm, I will set it at 32 degrees. You may have noticed there is a box to the right of the temperature alarm settings with the word hold next to it. If you want the data logger to inform you of an alert condition, even after conditions return to normal, check the box. This can help you in case something happens, such as a temporary loss of power. Finally, you'll be asked when you wish to have the data logger start reading. You can choose either immediate or at a specific date and time. If you choose immediate, you may receive an alarm as the device has not had time to adjust to the environment. That said, I'm going to select to start reading in about an hour, then press finish. The thermometer can now be safely ejected from the USB port and placed in the desired location. Periodically, you will want to check the thermometer for any alarms. A green single flash means the data logger is currently logging and there are no alarms. If there is a green double flash, the data logger is currently not logging, but is primed to start at a later time. A green and amber single flash means the memory is full and the data logger has stopped logging. However, there were no alarms. A red single flash means the data logger is currently logging, but there is a low temperature alarm. A red double flash means the data logger is currently logging, but there is a high temperature alarm. A red and amber single flash means the memory is full and has stopped logging. A low alarm was also triggered. A red amber double flash means the memory is full and has stopped logging. A high alarm was also triggered. An amber single flash means the battery is running low. Data logging will continue but will stop when the battery drops below 2.8 volts. No LEDs flashing? The data logger was not started or has stopped. The data logger hasn't been primed, the battery is dead, or one needs to be installed. For your convenience, here is a list of LED codes and their meaning. You can download the data from the data logger to your computer at any time. Remove the cap from the data logger and plug it into the USB port on the computer that has EasyLog USB installed. After launching EasyLog USB, select Stop the USB Data Logger and Download Data. You will get a prompt asking if you are sure you want to stop the logger and download the data. Select Yes. A message will appear saying that the data logger has been stopped. You will see the name of the data logger and the number of readings that it took. Press OK and a window will appear that will allow you to select where to save the file and option to give the file a different name. Click Save and the download will begin. After a few moments, a window with a graph will appear. Looking at the graph, you should notice three lines. The two differently dotted lines show the high and low alarm settings. The solid line represents the recorded temperature. At the very bottom, you can see the date and time range the data logger was reading. If you use your mouse, you can scroll over the graph. Look at the bottom of the window, and you can view the details of the reading at that particular time and date. If you don't wish to see this data, you can right-click on the mouse and select No Tools. Clicking on Result Tools will restore the view. Below the graph, you will see the graph legends with a checkbox, Fahrenheit, Low Alarm, and High Alarm. If you uncheck the box next to the name of the legend, that line will be removed from the graph. Of course, if you put a check back in the box, the line will return. You can select a range to close in on by creating a box around a selected area. You can return to normal viewing by right-clicking on the mouse and select Clear Zoom. You can also click on the magnifying glass with a minus sign in it. There are also other viewing options that will help you read the details from the log file. Click on Mark Samples and you will see dots appear on the solid line. Each dot represents the moment the data logger recorded a reading. If you check the option again, the dots will be removed. Click on Statistics and a window will appear on the right. The current view will show you the details of the area of the graph that is selected. Since the entire reading is displayed, you will see the general statistics from start to finish. If you have selected a range, the details of only that area will appear. Click on Data View and you will see the data in the text view instead of a graph. This is an easy way to scan the recorded temperatures. You will see that some temperature readings are in red, which indicates a high reading, and some are in blue, which indicates a low temperature reading. If you wish, you can click on the icon Show Alarms Only in the upper right corner to view only the alarm readings. Click on it again, and the non-alarm readings will return. You may also have noticed that the data logger serial number appears on this screen. To return to the graph, click on Graph View. Let's take a look at other actions you can perform from the menu. Click on the folder to load other data that has already been saved. Click the disk to save the data that you are currently viewing. This is useful to save the data to another location. The watch face opens a window to allow you to type in a desired date and time range to view. Export provides multiple options to output your data and graphs to different formats. CSV data. Saving the data in this format will allow you to import it into another application. JPEG graph. To save an image of the graph in the common image format. PDF data. To save the data in text form in a PDF image format. PDF graph, same as JPEG graph but can be saved in PDF format. Excel format, save both the data and graphic in a format that can be used by Microsoft Excel. The summary report creates a professional looking PDF graph that contains a complete summary report. You can also click on the drop-down menu options to make your selection. You can review downloaded data anytime you wish by clicking on View Previously Saved Data from the main menu. After you click on the button, simply browse to where you save your data and select the file you wish to view. After you have downloaded the data from your data logger, it will need to be reprimed in order to use it again. Easy enough. Just click on Setup and start the USB data logger from the main menu and repeat the same procedure at the beginning of the video. You will need to go through the wizard again, but all your previous selections will remain. If you have no changes to make, simply keep clicking Next until you reach the last screen. Again, choose when you wish to start reading, then click Finish. All set and your data logger is ready for a new reading session. Thank you for watching. We hope this video has helped you. If so, please click the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you'll be notified of any future videos. Also, check out our website and browse our large inventory of solutions.